protein egg, right? And it's very healthy. I have a term that I like to say, probably this Dr. Vic is going to say it, but I like to say an egg a day is okay, right? I really like to use that term. So I'm representing Caribbean Chicken. As you know, this we are teaming up with Belize Poultry Association. So my name is Mr. Wilfred Wincam. I work on the food safety section for the HACCP. HACCP team, have you ever heard about food safety? You know what is food safety all about? Okay, food safety is based more on the protection of the product, right? So ensure that the chicken is being it's being processed on a sanitary way. So when it reaches to the market, to your table, it should be actually as wholesome as it should be, right? So we are working over there on a standard together with Baja to ensure that you guys, Belize, have the best in the market. No? So we are focusing more into the health of the consumer. We are focusing more on the ensuring that Belize goes in that level. And one of our aim is to go international too and regional too. No? That's our aim. So we are glad that your school opened up the door for us to be over here. So thank you once more on behalf of Caribbean Chicken, the whole staff. So I will just leave you with Dr. Vic. He's going to talk a little more about the eggs and this. Thank you.
Thank you. So I'm a veterinarian. Veterinarian is an animal doctor. So I just want to encourage you to do well at school, do well in your, if you want to be an animal doctor, a veterinarian, you need to do well in your math and the science, the biology. Today we want to talk to you about eggs, because I work with the Belize Poultry Association and I am their doctor for the chickens, and to see that everything is healthy for the Belize people, right? I want to encourage you to eat more eggs, and let me tell you why. For 8 years now, we've been feeding eggs to school children in San Ignacio. I have a program there where we have a kitchen, cafeteria, and the children from Nazarene School, Big Nazarene, from the Anglican School, and from the public school in San Ignacio, come to us every morning for breakfast. What we have seen with those kids is that they are growing taller. Mm-hmm. Because malnutrition is a problem in Belize. Children are stunted, they're not growing the potential that they have because they're not eating well. And that is why egg is so important, because egg has the carbohydrates, has the energy, has the protein. One egg doesn't have a lot of calories, so if you don't want to put on weight, eat eggs. It has 70 calories and it has 6 grams of protein, and I call it the mineral or the vitamin pill. You know how some people, they take vitamins, they swallow vitamins? If you eat an egg, it's like taking a vitamin pill, because the egg has 14 nutrients, vitamins, it has minerals, as well as the protein that I talked to you about. Why is egg so important? I already told you that it helps with malnutrition. It helps with children not getting smarter, growing the potential that they should grow. And we're finding out that the pregnant ladies, so if you have in your family or your auntie or somebody that is pregnant, you also need to tell them to eat more eggs. Because when the lady that is pregnant eats eggs, the baby inside her forms well. Sometimes some people have problems with preterm babies. Instead of the 9 months, they are born at 7 months. When you eat eggs, it has been shown that you will go the term birth. Also showing that some babies sometimes are born with the spine open. It doesn't close. When you eat eggs, it has a vitamin in there that prevents that. So when you want your baby to be born normal time, normal length, and the weight, and the term, eat eggs. So the mother needs to eat eggs to feed the baby. It's very important for moms to eat eggs. Also when she is giving the baby milk, the egg helps that milk to be very nutritious. The milk is already nutritious for the baby, but when you eat eggs, it is even richer now for the baby. So the baby has good brain development, So when it goes to school, it will have a well-formed brain and it will have good memory, remember things very well. Okay, so very important then for the mother when she's pregnant, when she's feeding or breastfeeding the baby, and then for the baby. I don't know yet what age the leadership has recommends that you start to give solid foods to babies. But normally it would be like 12 months. And right now they're trying to bring it down even closer to 9 months, where you can introduce eggs to little babies, because the egg is very, very nutritious. It's going to help them with their brain development, with the development of their eyesight, to be very strong, and also will make them very intelligent at school. So we're starting to give eggs at a younger age. Once they've finished breastfeeding, we introduce eggs, because sometimes parents would wait. People would have some problems where they say, well, egg causes heart disease. And a lot of people are dying of heart attacks and heart problems. Science has now shown that egg is not related to heart disease. What causes heart disease is the diet, of course. But what is in the diet that causes heart disease is more the saturated fats. The cholesterol in eggs, the body already has its own cholesterol. So even without eating anything, you already have cholesterol. When you eat stuff that has cholesterol, then you add 40% more what your body produces. Egg has some cholesterol, but the cholesterol in eggs is the good one. And when you go and get some blood tests, the doctor says, let me check your cholesterol. So, oh, you have bad cholesterol, you have good cholesterol. The cholesterol in eggs helps the good cholesterol in your body. So it's excellent. The other thing about the egg the fat is 1.6 grams of saturated fat. It has 5 grams of total fat, but the cholesterol and the saturated fat that causes problems in people is 1.5 grams, so it's not a lot. If you compare it with, let's say, a biscuit, if you buy a biscuit at the store, at any Chinese store you're going to buy a biscuit, that biscuit may have already 3 grams of saturated fat. And you won't eat just one biscuit, you may eat 2 or 3 or 5. So that's a lot of saturated fat. And then we say, I don't want to eat eggs because it's bad for the heart. And the egg is only going to give you 1.5 grams of saturated fat. The biscuit gives you 3, and if you eat 5, you get 15 grams. You see how much more your diet is important? So include eggs in your diet, and you can eat it anyway. I like to boil eggs because then I can boil 9 of them today, and then I can eat 2 today, 2 tomorrow, 3 next day. We're finding that the children are feeding eggs. We've been feeding them eggs, and the children have come across from infants. A little boy came, our principal, he was having a lot of
animamos a todas las mamás allá que le den a los niños, a sus hijos, más huevos para comer. Porque el huevo es como una pastilla de vitamina. Trae bastantes vitaminas, trae bastantes minerales, tiene proteína de muy buena calidad. Es la mejor proteína natural que uno puede comer. Entonces, cuando el niño o la niña come un huevo al día, por lo menos, el niño está comiendo vitaminas, minerales, proteína, que le ayuda en su desarrollo. No solo va a crecer la altura que tiene la potencial para crecer, pero también va a tener su cerebro bien desarrollado. Entonces, va a poder usar su cerebro muy bien, va a poder concentrarse mejor, va a poder recordar cosas mejor, va a poder hacer mejor en la escuela. Nosotros hemos o conocemos niños que han venido a nuestro programa que han podido comer 2 huevos todos los días, ya de 7 años, y nosotros hemos visto cómo esos niños han crecido, se han desarrollado. Los niños son más inteligentes, ya no tienen problemas en la escuela de que se quedan un año, que se atrasan. No, esos niños están año a año, están yendo a diferentes clases porque están recordando mejor, buena memoria, y eso es lo que el huevo ayuda. Proteína, energía, vitaminas, minerales, muy bueno para el desarrollo. El huevo no solo es bueno para los niños, pero también para nosotros los adultos. No hay problema con eso del corazón, no hay problema con eso si tenemos diabetes, no hay problema si tenemos la presión muy alta. El huevo nos ayuda para que tengamos una vida más saludable. Entonces, hoy en día, en todo el mundo, todas las asociaciones de corazón están diciendo, ya nos damos un límite a cuántos huevos usted pueda consumir. Los mexicanos consumen 400 huevos por persona al año. Entonces, eso quiere decir que ya están comiendo más de un huevo al día. En Belice no estamos casi en la mitad de eso. Debemos de consumir más huevos, porque es buena proteína, nos ayuda a sentirnos satisfechos, llenos. Entonces, no tenemos esa tendencia de comer cualquier cosa y nos ayuda para mantener un peso normal. No vamos a estar muy gordos, y en Corozal se dice que la gente más gorda de todo Belice está en Corozal. Entonces, queremos rebajar. Entonces, el huevo nos va a ayudar en todo eso. Porque se ha visto en todo el mundo de los beneficios de comer huevo. Y entonces hay que hacer la propaganda, hay que hacer la educación, hay que decirle a la gente de todos los beneficios que tiene el huevo. Igual como los cristianos, nosotros hablamos, hay que decir las buenas nuevas del evangelio. Entonces estamos dando nosotros lo bueno de los beneficios del huevo, que ya hablamos hace poco de todos esos beneficios. Entonces son muy buenos. El huevo no es caro. El huevo se consigue en todos lados, se puede conseguir el huevo. Entonces es fácil para conseguir, es fácil para comprar. Entonces, si usted es pobre o si usted es rico, el huevo no cuesta mucho. Usted puede comer huevo en donde sea, como usted le guste.